Hey guys, and welcome back to another YouTube video on my channel. Hey guys, it's me, MSN11, and I'm going to be doing something different today. I'm doing a gaming setup video. Recently, it was my birthday. I'm not going to tell you when. Actually, no, I will. The 11th of July was my birthday, about a week ago. And I got a bunch of money, and I was able to spend it on quite a few things to enhance this setup and maybe do some new videos with cool stuff in the future. And some of this stuff was bought in previous months. I did a gaming setup video before, but I deleted it, took it down because I don't know why, because I just did it. And so I'm going to do it again. I'm going to run through from the beginning. So I'm going to start over here. Don't ignore this. This is an old antique Mac. This one here is my newer Mac. I know some people won't like that because they're PC people. But this is the 2011 Mac Mini here, the little box that sits behind this monitor. So this is the, and that's where I do all my editing on here on iMovie. So very, very cheap. Besides the Mac, the software was free, so iMovie is free with Macs, so that's good. This monitor is a 20-inch Mac Cinema display from 2008 or something, some really old thing. I got it off eBay for cheapish at the time. On the top here, I have my Western Digital Passport hard drive. That's 1 terabyte. It isn't even half, not even 100 gigs full of that, and that's crazy. I got a Logitech camera, never used that, and if you guys ask me to use that in videos, I probably won't. And my wireless keyboard and mouse. Here I have the microphone that makes my voice happens on the YouTube videos so that you guys can hear me. And what I did last time, this mic was just sitting here with its little legs, which I took its legs off. I don't know if that was like, I don't know, that bodily harm, I don't know, something. And then I bought a broadcast mic stand, so it sits out here and even further down, depending on how low I'm sitting and how far I want it to stretch out, so that I can sit here where my chair would normally be, and you guys can hear me up close. And when it's up, when the mic's close to my mouth, it eliminates background noise really well. So that's the broadcast mic. And something else that mixes the, or you need the audio from the mic to mix with the video. So down here is my Elgato Game Capture HD. I don't even know if you can read the writing. Yep, you can. I'm focused on it. You can read the writing. That's currently plugged into my Xbox 360, but here you can see there's an Xbox One on this here, and on top is the new Kinect sensor. But also what's new on this area, if I refocus, is this BenQ monitor. I got a completely new BenQ monitor. It's an RL2455HM, I believe. That is what it's called. If it's not, I'll type it on the screen. But I got this for $200 at JB Hi-Fi, is what it's called. It's basically a, if you're an American, it's the same thing as Best Buy, but Best Buy's a little bigger because everything in America is kind of bigger, right? So that is my gaming monitor with my new Xbox One here and the 360 in the same cabinet. We'll get onto the cabinet. Right here, though, is my headset, my new headset that I bought a while ago. It's not new anymore. I bought it back in March, but the headset's down on the floor. Let me pick that up. So this is the Plantronics rig. Currently, the headphones are kind of flipped around. Let me sit them up the right way. This is the Plantronics rig. It's a universal headset for mobiles, PCs, Xbox 360, and PlayStation 3. You can plug it into basically anything. It's got a mixer on it, which makes it awesome. So there's master volume, which is at the top. This is chat down here. This is game, so you can mix how loud you want your chat and your game volume to be. And over here, if you flick this big thing in the middle, you get a phone. You can plug your phone in through here and you can listen, you can have calls, and when you flick it to there, the mic on the headset actually is your mic for the phone. I'll put a link in the description so you can see how the entire rig works from their company video. Move over here. Here is the Xbox 360 and Xbox One in the top cabinet here, above all of my big boxes of everything in the Minecraft pickaxe in the picture. Down here, as you go further along, there's a 360 here, but the 360 games are over this side. Here's the Xbox One, and the Xbox One games are over here. I put that way because there's, as you can see, there's a pattern. Each second one, like this, like a chessboard, has a back on it, and the other one doesn't have a back. I have 4 Xbox 360 controllers, and they'd fall out the back, so that's why I need a back on that one. There's my games that I still have. Every other game I don't play, I trade in. Over here's the Xbox One games, which I have. Call of Duty Ghost, Need for Speed Rivals, Assassin's Creed 4, and some download tokens like Titanfall and Forza 5. That's what I have currently. as my Xbox One controller turned on. I also bought a stereo headset adapter from Microsoft so that I can actually use my 360 headset, the Plantronics rig, with the Xbox One, which is really good. Didn't have to buy a new headset, I only had to buy a new adapter. And this is just cords, cables, and random shit for the rest of that. So that is basically my desk and gaming setup. I ran through that pretty quickly. This is what it feels like to be MSN11, record YouTube videos. Plus, just to make it all the more cooler, I have these lights, LED lights, with a 12 different colored remote thing. Sorry, the flash is on my phone because that cabinet was dark. So you can change a bunch of colors and different modes as well. You can change things like strobes so that it flashes different colors, or you can put it on a fade so it fades through the rainbow, stuff like that. But with the Xbox One, I like to color it the same color as my background, and the 360, I like to keep it green, like that. Thanks everyone for watching, and I hope you have a great day. I'll see you on another video, and goodbye.